Hi everyone, this is Bilal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. In the last video, we set up the room for handling the local database. And now, we can use it to save the user in our local database. But before doing this, in this video, we will learn how we can simplify the retrofit calls using coroutines. And for those who don't know what is coroutine in Kotlin, I will soon create a separate course to explain about coroutines. In this course, we cannot do this, but for a basic understanding, coroutine is a new way of writing asynchronous code, and it is awesome, guys. As you know, when we call NQ with the retrofit API as we did here, we are calling NQ, it is an asynchronous call. And it looks ugly and it is very complicated. So in this video, we will simplify this thing. And trust me, you will love it. So let's start. And right now, we are also returning the response body from our API call. And we can also parse this response directly using the JSON converter that we add while creating the retrofit API that we just did here. You can see we have added a converter factory, and this can be used to directly pass this response to Kotlin classes, and we will do this thing as well in this video. So this response that we are getting here is a JSON object, and we can directly map it to a Kotlin class. And for this, we need to create a Kotlin class. So inside our project, and inside this network package, I will create one more package to store all the classes that we will use to map the JSON response into Kotlin classes. So let's create a package name responses. And inside this package, I will create a Kotlin file class and I will name it auth response. And this is a class, and we will create a data class for this, because this class will do nothing. It will just store the JSON response, and we will make a data class. And to this data class, we will define isSuccessful message and user. Well, isSuccessful, and this is of type Boolean, and I will make all the values nullable. Then we have message of type string. Then we have user of type user, as this key contains a user and another JSON object. And to map this object, we already created our user entity in the last video. You see? So for the last attribute of our auth response, we are using user type here. And we also need to import the user, and we are done. Now when we will pass the wrong password to our login API, we will not get the user. So we will receive user as null. So we have the data class auth response to directly parse our JSON response to Kotlin classes, or you can say Kotlin objects. This is the correct statement. Now come back to my API, and here instead of this call, I will define response. Now this time this user login function will give us a response, and the type of this response is auth response. We also need to import response and make sure you import the retrofit response. Now you need to make your function suspend. Now here we are using this keyword suspend, and that makes this function suspending. And suspending functions are the center of everything in coroutines. A suspending function is simply a function that can be paused and resumed at a later time. So these type of function can execute a long running operation and wait for it to complete without blocking. As our function userLogin performs a network operation, and it is a long running operation. So that is why we need to make it suspend. And now this time it is not returning us a call, but it is returning us a response of type auth response. I hope it is clear for you. Now, after making the changes in our interface My API, we will go to our user repository. And here you can see we don't have the NQ now because we don't have the call returned by this function anymore. Now here, first we will change the return type of our user login function. And right now it is giving us a live data of type string. And I will change it to response of type auth response. So now this function will directly return us the auth response. And we will remove everything inside this function. So delete everything. And now we need to write only a single line here. So what we will do, we will write return, then we will create our My API instance. And again, this is not a good practice, but for now we will use it like this. And later we will fix it. So we have My API, then we will call the user login function and we will pass the email and the password. But now you will get an error and it will say suspend function user login should be called only from a coroutine or another suspend function. So for now, I will make this function suspend as well because we are calling a suspend function. So either we need to make the calling function suspend or we need to call this function from a coroutine scope. But now we do not want to use the coroutine scope. So that is why I made this function suspend as well. I hope you got the point. Now this function will return us the response that will contain our auth response. And now we have done with the user repository class and you can see how much it is simplified now. And let's remove these useless imports. You can see we have a clean and concise code now. Now we will call this user login function from our view model. And if you come here, you have an error, you can see. And we have the same error that suspend function user login should be called only from a coroutine or another suspend function. But you just cannot make all the functions suspend. So here, to make this call user login, I will create a coroutine function. And I will do it inside my util package. And here I will create a new Kotlin file class and I will name it coroutines. And here I will define all the functions that I need for my coroutines. And to define all the functions, I will use an object so that I can directly call the functions with the help of this coroutines object. It is similar to static in Java, but we call it object in Kotlin. Now inside this object, I will define a fun main. And this function will take another function as a parameter. And it will take a coroutine function. So it will take a suspend function. And for this suspend function, we don't have any parameters. And we will get the return as unit. And unit in Kotlin is equivalent to void in Java. Now this function will return us a job. So I will simply write here equals to and then I will call coroutine scope, which is this coroutine scope. And for this coroutine scope, I will define the thread that it should use. So it will use the main thread. That is why I have named this function main. That means I'm going to execute it in the main thread. So here we will define dispatchers, which is again a part of Kotlin. And we have four options here. Default, IO, main, and unconfined. And we are going to use main from here. So we have the coroutine scope main. And then we will call launch and the launch returns a job and this job is returned by this main function. And inside this launch, we will perform this work. and that's it. It might be confusing for you, and if you want to understand it better, you need to learn about higher order functions and lambda in Kotlin. And maybe I will create a separate video to explain these things. But for now, this is the function. This function is taking another function as a parameter, and we are executing that function here. So basically, this is what this function means. Now, we can use this main to call our user login inside auth view model. So here, I will delete this thing. Actually, I will delete everything. And here I will write val response equals to, and then again we will use our user repository, and we will fix this thing later using dependency injection. But for now, let's use like this. So we have user repository and then user login. We will pass the email and the password. And again, we are getting an error, like we should call it from a coroutine scope. And we already defined the coroutine. So we will use this to call our user login. And to do this, I will write here coroutines dot main, which is the name of our function. And I will put it inside this main. That's it. Now you can see the error is gone and we have the response. The type of this response is response of type auth response. So here we can check if response is successful. So if the response is successful, that means the user is logged in or authenticated. So in this case, I will call auth listener dot on success, and this time I will pass response dot body dot user like this, and I will make sure it is not null. But our on success function is taking a live data as a parameter, so we need to change our on success function declaration. And here, instead of this live data, it will accept a user this time. That's it. Come back to view model and you can see the error is gone. Now inside our login activity, we need to change this thing here as well. And this time we will receive a user in our on success function. And here we can simply display a toast like $user.name. And it will display the name of the user is logged in. And for now, we will just display the toast, and in later videos, we will save this user to our local database. So we have done with the onSuccess function. Now come back to your auth view model. And here, in case of any error, that means when the response is not successful, we will call auth listener dot on failure, and here we will pass error code, and we will get the error code from the response. So we will write response dot code. That's it. Now let's check the failure function in our login activity, and it is good. We are displaying the toast and we are hiding the progress bar, and we need to hide the progress bar inside on success as well. Now everything is good and it should work. So let's try running our application. Let's try login in. We are getting the progress bar and we are getting the toast that Bilal Khan is logged in. If I write a wrong password, then in this case, we are getting the error code 401. That means unauthorized. So it is working absolutely fine. And you can see how much simplified our network calls are. You can see only a single line of code. And before it was too much. So just with the help of coroutines, we simplified our network calls, and it is very awesome. Now we can write so many network calls in our application like this. So we will learn these things in the coming videos. But for now, that's it, friends. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. In case you have any question, then let me know in the comments. And you can also download the source code. The link is in the description of this video. And please share this video if you want me to keep creating courses for you. Thanks for watching. This is Bilal Khan now signing off.